In this video, I'm going to be talking about hooks. Now, I'm not talking about the kind of hooks you hang Christmas lights on. I'm talking about hooks in your WordPress theme. I'm going to tell you everything about it, how to use these to do more with your website. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I release a ton of content to help you get better results with WordPress faster. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, and links to everything that I talk about throughout the video will be linked in the video description box below. So I'm talking about web hooks, hooks in your WordPress-based theme. So I'll give you a couple examples. Here is a website, and you see this large call to action on the top. Well, this is essentially a piece of content hooked into what's called the hook area that is above the header of this theme. Have you ever been to a blog and you're reading the post and you scroll down to the bottom and then there's this really interesting call to action where they're maybe trying to offer you something in exchange for your email address and it's on every single post? That's also a bit of content that you can hook into this area at the end of the content of a blog post. These are called hooks. Now, all the themes that I talk about pretty much support hooks. So if you're an Astra fan, I am using this particular theme. It has hooks included, and it's actually included for free. So you can download the free Astra theme, and you can download the hooks add-on and add these hooks to your WordPress-based website all for free. Here is the free add-on. It's very unique that they offer it for free because usually this is something that you have to pay for. It's not going to be found in a free theme. If you like GeneratePress, there is an add-on. If you have GeneratePress Premium, that you can add this hooks functionality to your website. And if you are an Ocean WP fan, you have this as an option as well. It comes in the extension bundle. Now, in this video here, I'm going to demonstrate how to use hooks and how you're most likely going to use it with your page builder. So here I have a website with Astra installed. I want to demonstrate the free functionality of hooks. So I have Astra installed here. Now, what you're going to need to install Astra, go to plugins, and there's going to be a plugin that you need to install called Astra Hooks. Now, they also have another plugin that you can add to understand these hooks a little better. So here, let me actually go to the front end of this site. So this is how the website looks right now, just a normal website. But if I activate this Astra theme visual hooks like this, then I go here and I refresh the page, you're going to see all these hook areas. So here are the hook areas above the header. Here are the hook areas below the header. Now, since this is a page, the rest of the hooks are going to pretty much be above the footer and below the footer. These are areas that you can hook designs into. So if you have a design where it's a call to action, you're going to be able to hook it into here. And I'm going to show you how to do that with most page builders and any theme that supports hooks like this. Now, if you are looking at a blog post, you'll see some of the specific hook areas for that. There's hook areas for above the sidebar, below the sidebar, above the content, and below the content on a blog post. So if we're looking back at this blog post, this would be below the content area of a blog post. If we're looking here, this is going to be above the header. So those are the main locations. Now, if you did activate this plugin, you're going to want to deactivate it because it will drive you crazy. You obviously don't want anyone coming to your website and have it look like this. Let me do a refresh here and it should all go away. Okay, so I'm going to show you where to put this content in with Astra, GeneratePress, and with the other theme, Ocean WP. Okay, so I'm going to go into appearance and customize. So Astra is the only one where they actually are accessible in the customizer. So here I am in the customizer, and we have this option here that says hooks, and here are the various hook areas. Now, you can actually put anything in these hook areas. You can start typing text. If you have a page builder that supports saving things, and then you can use short codes to display those wherever in a theme, you can do that. And this is also the ideal location to put those little snippets of code that you get for various things. So if you want to add Google Analytics to your website, it gives you a little bit of a tracking code, and you're going to want to put that into one of these hook areas. So there's a lot of purposes for this. So at the very basic level, I could just start typing something right right here where it says before header. So let me go ahead and enter something. There it is. All I entered was this is my first hook, and you can see the information that I just put in this hook area appeared right there. Now you can have formatted HTML if you want to do that, but if you're using a page builder, there's going to be a much easier way to leverage these different hook areas. Now when you do put something in one of these hook areas, it will be global on your site. So every single page or post will show whatever you put in this hook area. Now, you're pretty much not going to want to do it this way. This is how I like to leverage the hooks. Let me get out of the customizer right here. Now, on this particular website, I have Elementor, but I'm also going to demonstrate this using Beaver Builder. Now, with Elementor, if you have Elementor Pro, when you save things to the library, check this out. I'm going to go to my library. It adds this column here that says short code, and you can just copy and paste this out. Now, I've already created a saved section called header call to action, and it generated this short code. So I can click on it, go ahead and put that into my clipboard, and now I'm going to take this short code and I am going to put it in one of these hook locations. So here's hooks. I'm going to go to header, and I'm going to put it before header just like this. So when I paste my short code in, you can see it's going to show this call to action that I created. I put very limited to no effort into. You could do some better things. I'd probably move this a little more to the center, tighten this up a little bit. But you could see that's as simple as it is. Now, if I wanted it after the header, I can go right here and I can paste it in right there. And we're going to see this call to action is right there underneath the header. So with Astra, these hook areas are going to be accessible in the customizer. I really like that because you get this, what you see is what you get. Now, if you're using GeneratePress and their hooks, it's actually going to be an option found in the back end of WordPress. So you're going to go to Appearance, and then you'll have this option that says GP Hooks. And you'll see it pretty much has the same exact thing in the same exact locations right here. Now, if you go to Ocean WP, it's pretty much going to be the same experience. Here's a little screenshot. It's going to be underneath theme panel and then underneath hooks right there. And you can see it's pretty much the same thing. You would just go ahead and paste your short code in. You can see I've got that there. So let me go ahead and remove that. Now, there are these other hook locations. So for content, it's going to be before your content. And there's all these different hook locations as you saw when I showed you that visual hook guide. There's hooks before and after comments, sidebar, and footer. So I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. Now, there is another way of doing this. These are basic hooks, right? You just put it in and it shows globally. Now, if you have Astra Pro or you're a coder, you can accomplish this definitely with some custom code. I'm not a coder and I have no interest in learning custom code. Now, if you have Astra Pro, let me demonstrate this other functionality, and I'm also going to demonstrate it using Beaver Builder. Now, Beaver Builder is a little different with these short codes. You can save sections and you can display those with the short code, but it's not as easy. It doesn't give you the short code like Elementor did. So if you Google Beaver Builder short code, it's going to take you to this page. I'll also put a link to it in the video description down below. Now, when you scroll down, it's going to show you how to write these short codes out. So essentially, it's going to be this short code, but we need to find something called a page slug and put it in right there. And that's all there is to it. So actually, let me go ahead and toss this into my clipboard. Okay, now let me demonstrate dynamic hooks. Now, if you have Astra Pro, so here's Astra's website, here's Astra Pro. I have a link to this down below. If you buy it, I'm an affiliate. I'll earn a small amount of money. There's this feature right here, dynamic hooks. Now, what a dynamic hook is, say you want to put that short code in, but you might only want it to show on the homepage. Or say you might want to have something show at the top just above the header only on blog posts or only on certain types of content. Or if someone's logged in versus not logged in, you could do that all with this dynamic hooks that comes with Astra Pro. Astra Pro is actually very cheap. Right now it's only $49. That might go up to $69 soon, but you can get it for $49 or a lifetime license for $199. Let me show you how to do this with Beaver Builder with the dynamic hooks. Obviously, these dynamic hooks will work perfectly fine with Elementor as well. I just wanted to demonstrate all these different systems. So what we need to do is we need to go to Appearance. We click on Astra right here, and here is the tab for all of these extensions that come with Astra Pro. Here it is, Advanced Hooks. I've already activated it, and so we have it right here under Advanced Hooks. So I've gone ahead and created this advanced hook right here. You basically just give it a name, and then you put your content here. So you know how I demonstrated putting in the content in the customizer? Well, with these dynamic hooks, we would just do it here in the back end. So you can type whatever you wanted. And you can also, if you didn't want to put a short code in, you could style it however you wanted with the typical editor that you get with WordPress. And then right here is where the magic happens. So first you want to choose the hook location in this dropdown. And here is a list of all the locations. So I'm going to put this at the header top. So this will be above the header. And right here, you're going to choose the display options, and that's pretty much where the magic happens. So if I wanted it on the entire website, I would click this. But if I didn't want it on the entire website, and I just wanted it, say, on all pages, all posts, a particular page, a particular post, or maybe blog posts with a certain tag or from a certain category, you have all these options right here. It couldn't be more simple. So I'm going to first just demonstrate it on the entire website right here. Now, right here, you also have the option of user role. So this could be if someone has a particular role on your website or if they're logged in or logged out. So I'm going to leave that as is. So I've enabled it to be across the website. Oops, I never pulled up the website to begin with. So here is the website without it. Beautiful website, by the way. And this is free with the Astra Sites plugin. So, all right, I'm going to go ahead and click on update. I'm going to go right here, do a refresh. And there it is. There's my call to action created in Beaver Builder. Now, I have Beaver Builder version 2 on this website. Here, let me disable it really quick. I want to just show you where to find and where to save sections and where to find it with the Beaver Builder version 2. So here I am on the site. Let me do a refresh and you'll see this has gone away. I'm going to go into Beaver Builder 2. By the way, I'm going to do a full review on Beaver Builder 2. It's really, really neat. So what I want to do here is I'm going to click on this plus. I'm going to go to rows because I saved it. So right here, I'm going to change this to saved rows. And here is my saved row. The way you save a row is super easy in Beaver Builder. You can go to any row like this, go into the wrench icon for the row, and you can click save as, and you can save that row very easily. So let me get out of there. Now, the way you find out that slug, it's kind of a pain, but let me show you. So essentially take the name that you save that row as and any space, put it all in lowercases, any spaces replaced with a hyphen, and you're pretty much set. So let me actually show that to you. So I have the saved rows here. If I want to edit it, I click on this little wrench, it opens up in a new tab, and I can go ahead and edit anything that I want in that saved row, and then I can go ahead and save it. It's a little few extra steps. I do have a full Beaver Builder 2.0 review video coming out where I'm going to cover all these new little intricacies with Beaver Builder. Also in the URL here, you can see the slug right there. So it's after FL Builder template. It's that little bit there, CTA, that is the one. Now, I just covered it in these three themes, and I also talked about Elementor and Beaver Builder. There's also Thrive Architect, which doesn't have this functionality right now. There's also Divi, which I don't believe you can use short codes, and I don't think the theme has a visual hook, dynamic hook thing that I was showing you. So there's some disadvantages there. So anyways, these are hooks. You're primarily going to use it for maybe if your website has a sale or a promotion or someplace where you want to draw someone's attention to, or maybe have an opt-in box or something like that. It's very powerful if you leverage it, especially the dynamic hooks that come with Astra Pro. It's very, very powerful. If you also have Beaver Themer, you get that dynamicness of the hook areas as well. So that's it for this short tutorial on using hooks. Everything that I talked about in this video will be linked in the description box. If you are going to purchase any of these things, if you don't have it, I'd appreciate it if you use the links in the description box. I tend to be an affiliate with any of these companies that does have an affiliate program, but I also like to throw something in like perhaps a training course. So some of those links might take you back to my website to give you information about any bonuses that I might be including in those purchases. Now, I want to hear from you some ideas on how to use hooks, leverage the power of hooks on websites. Any ideas that you have? I obviously showed some basic ideas, but I'd like to hear ideas of how you think hooks should be used or how you're currently using them on projects that you're doing right now. Once again, thanks for watching this video. Consider subscribing, give it a thumbs up, and leave a comment down below. And I appreciate you spending this time with me.